Another really important factoring skill is recognizing when you have sums and differences of perfect cubes. So we've talked in the past about how you deal with perfect squares, at least the difference between perfect squares. So try this example out. Say I've got this, like that. Okay? So go ahead and figure out what that's going to be. Remember, whenever you're multiplying stuff like this together, you're going to distribute this to all the terms, and then you're going to distribute this to all the terms. And you're going to sum up what you get. Okay? So let's start out summing up, this way. Summing these guys, or multiplying these guys, distributing, whatever. X cubed minus x squared y plus xy squared, and then plus x squared y minus xy squared plus y cubed. Now, let me reiterate that math is not a spectator sport, as every math teacher loves to say. If you're watching these videos, you need to be working these problems along. And in fact, pause the video, try to work them out, see if you're getting the same thing I'm getting, because otherwise you're just kind of staring at it and you're not actually getting much out of it. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe you are. Do whatever works. All right. So basically, what you can do is you can come up with the idea that both of these guys are going to cancel out, and both of these guys are going to cancel out. And when they cancel out, what you're left with is this here. Right, because all you're left with is this guy and this guy. So that gives us our next property, formula, thingy, that x cubed plus y cubed is equal to x plus y, x squared minus xy plus y squared. And then similarly, we could find that x cubed minus y cubed was equal to x minus y, x squared x plus xy plus y squared. And I wish I had a better way to say this, but these you've just got to commit to memory. You just got to, because, yeah, this is not something you're going to come up with on your own, whereas you might accidentally come up with this on your own. This is something I would never just arbitrarily think of. Oh, what would happen if I wanted the sum or the difference of two cubes? I just wouldn't come up with this. So, some similar or some things that might help you keep it straight is the thing that has the plus sign here has the plus sign here. See, the minus sign here has the minus sign here. And that this sign is always the opposite of the next one. So if this is a minus, the next one's a plus. These guys here are always pluses. This term's always squared. That term's always squared. So whatever it takes for you to keep these memorized and keep them straight in your head, that's what you want to go for. And again, it's all about pattern matching, and that's just the way I think. So if that doesn't work for you, try something else. But in general, that's kind of the strategy that I use when I'm trying to figure these problems out. So here, for example, we'd say, okay, so I've got x cubed. Now 8, I can rewrite as 2 cubed. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and set up my template and go from there. So since this is a plus sign here, that means that that's a plus and that's a minus. This guy's here is always a plus, and the first term and the last term over here are squared. So I kind of like to get that set up so that all I have to do is plug in my numbers and go from there. So I have an x and a 2. So there's my x and a 2. There's my x. And if you want, you can say, here's my x and a 2. Here's my x and a 2. And that's how it goes. In fact, if you want to make it easy, it doesn't really matter what order you say these in. So you could say there's an x and a 2, x and a 2, x and a 2. They just fill in like that. It's actually kind of fun. Now, if you're doing this on, an online homework system, or you're trying to turn in for a teacher who cares about you and wants you to learn it, they're going to want to make sure that you simplify that 2 squared and write that as 4. As a note to yourself, don't try to factor this. It won't. Pretty much ever. If you've pulled out all the like terms, if you pulled out all the like terms in the initial thing, so if this was 2x cubed plus 16, if you pulled that 2 out to begin with, then this absolutely will not factor. Okay, so that's kind of nice to know that once you get there, that's a little less work. So similarly, see what would happen if you're going to go x cubed minus 8. Since this here is a negative, that means that's going to be a negative and that's going to be a positive. This guy here is a positive, and these first and last terms are squared. So this is the x cubed minus 2 cubed. So x, 2, x, 2, x, 2. And I can just write it in x minus 2, x squared, minus 2x plus 4. Got it? All right, let's try this. Let's try something a little bit more fun. Try y cubed minus 27. And again, if you're following along at home, you know, pause the video, go try to work this out, see if it makes sense. Because if it doesn't make sense while you're watching the video, it's not going to make sense later. Unless, well, you could have a better professor who would be more helpful, in which case maybe it would make a lot more sense. But for the moment, we're doing this together. So this is a minus. So that means that this has to be a minus, this has to be a plus, this guy's is always a plus. There's my squared and squared. Y cubed, and I recognize that 27 is the same thing as 3 cubed. So y and 3, y and 3, y and 3. And I can rewrite this, y squared minus 3y plus 9. Just to do some more for funsies. Okay. Again, pause this, try to work it out. This guy here is a plus, so this is a plus, which makes that a minus and this a plus. And these two terms here are squared. Now pay attention here to what's going on. 64x cubed is the same thing as 4x, the whole thing cubed. Because again, remember that 3 applies to both of those guys. So 4 cubed and then x cubed. And again, 1 is the same thing as 1 cubed. Okay. So 4x, 1. Here's where you got to be careful. The whole 4x is going to need to be squared. So I'm going to put that in there like that. 4x, 1. 4x, and 1. This is probably the most important part to get right on this problem in particular. So 4x plus 1, 16x squared, minus 4x plus 1. And you're beautifully factored. About the worst they can do on a problem like this is give you something that looks really awful. That looks pretty bad. And in a problem like this, you always want to look for things that have common factors, because this is not a perfect cube. This is not a perfect cube. 16 is not a perfect cube. So try to work this out. Now, ideally, whenever I go through here, I can say, well, let's see, what do they have in common? Do they have a 4? No. An 8? No. If they don't have a 4, they won't have an 8. I'm not really sure, but I know they both have a 2. And so I'm going to pull out a 2. If it turns out I have to pull out more later, I can always do that. But for the moment, I'm just going to pull out a 2. And here I actually luck out, because I can see that this is actually a perfect cube. 3a cubed. 2b cubed. Those are both perfect cubes, which is excessively lucky. Well, not really lucky, because we're in that particular section. But in any case, we could pretend it's lucky. Minus makes that a minus, and the second one a plus. The last one's always a plus. Put in our squared terms. So here's 3a and 2b. 3a and 2b. 3a and 2b. 2 times 3a minus 2b. Remember, 3a quantity squared is 9a squared plus 6ab. 2b quantity squared is 4b squared. And again, don't factor this out, because you can't. Not that I'm forbidding it, it's not factorable with real numbers. So this is going to be what you would consider to be your final solution.